Alright, so we have Oxidus Scrap Melter, who's great, but we can't play, I don't think. Grasp of Darkness, which is a solid removal spell, but we are looking at a lot of double blue cards, so this really is more like a four drop in our deck, probably, by the time we'll actually have double black. I like Darksteel Sentinel quite a lot, actually, although it does die to Grasp of Darkness and Grim Affliction and such. But I think the card I want to take is actually going to be Perilous Mirror. This card is just a solid blocker, should be very good for us in general. I don't think we have anything to recur with Corpse Cur, so he would otherwise be worth considering, though, as a Gravedigger with Infect is actually pretty sweet. But we don't have any guys that he can actually get back. Alright. So here we have Necropede, which is basically Perilous Mirror. They're very similar, and I think they're both excellent. Bleak Coven and Blister Grab are both just like filler dudes that are okay that you play sometimes but aren't excited about. So I think we'll just grab the Necropede. This card is basically unplayable. Like if you have Metalcraft, you mill them a little bit. Who cares? And this card is okay but not great. You need a pretty dedicated Infect deck. Okay, we have Plague Stinger, who's actually not bad. Mirror Galvanizer, if we want to like go deep with our Mirror Turbine, which I'm pretty sure we do not want to do. This card's great, but we're not going to be metal crafting, so it's just going to be a 4-mana 2/2 flying, which is the opposite of great. I think we're just going to take the Plague Stinger. It'll be very good to side in against other Infect decks because they can't like pump over it. Basically, when you're putting minus one counters on their guys. Embersmith is by far the best card in this pack, but we can't take it, so too bad for us. Alright, Disperse is solid. You sometimes want one. I don't think we want one in this deck just because we have a Vapor Snag and a Quicksilver Geyser already. So adding Disperse to that mix doesn't really seem necessary. But it's a good option to have. I'm not sure when we'd board it in, but we might. Alright, Stoic Rebuttal is a fine counter spell. I can't really remember what this card does. It's pretty bad. We have like three creatures that are good to sacrifice. I guess Serum Raker can sometimes be good to sacrifice. I don't think we're interested in that. Although we do have a Turbine. Yeah, I guess we'll take it. I don't think Stoic Rebuttal is great, and I don't think it's really any better than the other one that we have, than the 4-mana one that we're probably not going to play. I think we don't need that many clunky counter spells, so having some diversity in options is probably good. All right, here we got some winners. This card is actually great. Looks kind of clunky, but it's very, very good, I think. Corrupted Harvester is a fine finisher, and we're kind of in the market for a finisher at this point. Flight Spellbomb is also just fine. It cycles, it can jump a guy to block or whatever. But I think I'll just take the Harvester. It's a little worse than I remember. I thought it just regenerated. I forgot that it has to sack a creature. We're gonna take the Flight Spellbomb, actually. Changing my mind after learning what cards do. Alright, this is another clunky counter spell, but at least this one, when it happens, is very good, so we'll be interested. We could also pick up a Bleak Coven or two, but I expect them to wheel. People kind of underrate this card, I think. The Metalcraft doesn't come up that often in general, usually, but it's still a 5-mana 4/3, which is not a bad creature. All right, so I'm gonna hide the Halt Order and the Fuel for the Cause. Alright, so we have Darksteel Mirror versus Stoic Rebuttal. I think I'm gonna take the Mirror. This card's very good against like the red-green monster-y kind of decks. It's obviously very bad against Infect, but it has its places that it's good. Probably not gonna make the main deck. Alright, so here we have a big dumb guy that untaps. I guess that's okay. Bonds of Quicksilver, which is kind of just a bad numbing dose, I think. I guess we'll just take the Soliton. We'll take the Bleak Coven for sure. We're almost certainly not going to play Soliton, but whatever. Don't really want any of these things. Hate some of the dinosaurs. Ooh, alright. Plated Sea Strider might actually make the cut. Card's not bad. Alright, so deck building. These are the ones I want for sure. Sea Strider, Halt Order, Mirren Spy, Serum Raker, Gambit Geyser. Yeah, these are the ones I want for sure. This is a maybe, this is a maybe, this is a maybe. I guess actually Despise is going to be pretty good in our deck because we have Quicksilver Geyser and Vapor Snag or Disperse, whichever one we want to play. So we'll be able to bounce a guy and remove it from their hand with some regularity if that is what we want to do. Yeah, I like the looks of this quite a bit. I think we'll go with Disperse and Despise as our last two cards. We could play Bleak Coven Vampires, and I think it would be pretty good. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 artifacts, but this one really counts as 2. It might be good in our deck. We might have too many 2-mana, like, gum-up-the-ground kind of guys. Or maybe we can, we'll sideboard Halt Order in favor of Bleak Coven Vampires. I think this will be better. If our opponent has something we really want to counter, we can bring in the Halt Order. Alright, let's see what Modo suggests for lands. 5-12, I don't think so. I think we're going to go with 10-7. Like, this doesn't really count as a blue card. We should not have I guess we can go with 11-6, actually. We don't have that many black cards in our deck, so that should be fine. Alright, we'll be back for the games.